In the last session, we have discussed about the cotton textile industry in India. And in this session, that is in the 21st session of industrial economics, we are going to discuss about the structure of iron and steel industry in India. So first of all, introduction. We live essentially in an age of iron and steel. Because of its hardness, strength and durability, because of the ease with which it can be cast and worked into any desired shape, and because of its remarkable cheapness under modern methods of production, iron is the most important and widely used metal in the service of man. Iron and steel were the harbinger of industrial revolution in the late 18th and early 19th century. Today, this industry has proved to be the harbinger of the globalization. It is one of the very few industries that have assumed a global character, with development in one region affecting the industry almost everywhere else, and India is no exception. Although Indians are known for their techniques of smelting iron since early time, the first iron and steel unit on modern lines was established in 1830 at Porto Novo in Tamil Nadu. However, it could not succeed and was closed down in 1866. The other efforts made during the second half of the 19th century also met with the same fate. So the structure of iron and steel industries can be explained as follows. The iron and steel industry in India is organized into three categories: main producers, other major producers and secondary producers. In 2004 and 5, the main producers, that is SAIL, TISCO and RINL, had a combined capacity of around 50% of India's total steel production capacity and production. The other major producers, that are SR, ISPAT and JVSL, accounts for about 20% of this total steel production capacity. So growth of iron and steel industries can be explained as follows. The real beginning of the modern iron and steel industry was made in 1907 only, when Tata Iron and Steel Company, that is TISCO, were set up at Jamshedpur, this is Sakchi at that time. The Indian Iron and Steel Company, that is IISCO, were set up in 1919 at Bumpur, followed by the setting up of Mysore Steel Works at Bhadravati. Now Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel, now this was renamed by Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel Works in 1923. Steel Authority of India, that is SAIL, established in 1973. SAIL is government undertaking and is responsible for the management of steel plants at Bhilai, Durgapur, Rourkela, Bokaro and Bampur, and also the Alloy Steel Plant and Durgapur and Salem Steel Plant. The management of Indian iron and steel was taken over by government on 14th July 1976. SAIL also took over Maharashtra Electro Smelt Limited, a mini steel plant, in January 1986. Vishveshwaraya Iron and Steel Limited were also taken over by SAIL in August 1989. So production of steel industry in the million ton can be explained with the following table. So in the era of 1950 and 51, the total production of steel was 1 million ton, which rose to 6.8 million tons in 1980 and 81, which again rose to 9.6 million tons in 1990 and 91. And by the era of 2011 and 12, the production of steel has risen to 73.4 million tons. Next one, locational factors. Most of the iron and steel plants of India, such as Jamshedpur, Bhompur, Durgapur, Rourkela, Bhilai and Bokaro, are located in Jharkhand, West Bengal, Orissa and Chhattisgarh. These states are very rich in coal and iron ore deposits and are important producers of these materials. So centers of production. At present, there are 10 primary integrated plants and a large number of decentralized secondary units known as mini steel plants. Besides, there are several rolling and re-rolling mills and foundries which manufacture different items of steel using pig iron and ingot steel. There are about 10,000 foundries, 95% of which are concentrated in the western state of Maharashtra and Gujarat and in the southern state of Tamil Nadu. Role of iron and steel industry in India. First point, Indian economy is in need of device to boost employment opportunities, raise income and its standard of living, and to bring a more balanced and integrated economy. Steel industry is the best solution for achieving all these goals. The prevailing capital for the promotion of steel industries are the plentiful supply of labor, largely favor and development of steel industries. Second point, while appraising the members about the future plans of the company mentioned in the sale is finalizing its vision 2025 document. This will steer the company to increase its production capacity of hot metal to 50 million tons along with related or enabling business activities. Third point, the company achieved a turnover of ₹50,627 crore during the financial year of 2014 and 15, which was almost the same level as that previous year, that was ₹51,866 crores. The profit after tax of the company for the financial year 2014 and 15 was ₹2,093 crores. Fourth point, the company acquires requisite technologies to progress raw materials as well as to produce steel in an environment friendly manner in the carbon constrained world. The company is finalizing its technology vision and also the environment vision. Fifth point, the India's iron and steel industry is the ready domestic availability of significant reserves of high quality iron ore, a key raw material input to steel marketing. Predominantly in the East India, although current steel production capacity is located in both the East. Sixth one, the government introduced special economic zones in June 2005 with aim of creating internationally competitive regions in which exporting business can base their operations. 8 of these zones are functional or under concentration, and approval has been given for an additional 18 zones. So, the next part is major problems faced by Indian iron and steel industries. So, some problems of the Indian iron and steel industries can be explained as the follows. The first problem is capital deficiency. Iron and steel industry requires large capital investment, which a developing country like India cannot afford. So next problem is lack of technology. Throughout the 1960s and up to the oil crisis in mid-1970s, Indian steel industry was characterized by a high degree of technological efficiency. This technology was mainly from abroad. But during the following two decades after the oil crisis, steep hike in energy cost and acceleration of cost of other inputs reduced the margin of profit of the steel plants. Third problem is low productivity. The per capita labor productivity in India is at 90 to 100 tons, which is one of the lowest in the world. The labor productivity in Japan, Korea, and some other major steel producing countries is about 600 to 700 tons per man per year. Fourth problem is inefficiency of public sector units. Most of the public sector units are plagued by inefficiency caused by heavy investment on social overheads, poor labor relations, inefficient management, underutilization of capacity, etc. This hinders proper functioning of the steel plants and results in heavy losses. Fifth point, low potential utilization. The potential utilization in iron and steel is very low. Rarely the potential utilization exceeds 80%. For example, Durgapur Jaipur steel plant utilizes only 50% of its potentials. This is caused by several factors like strikes, lockouts, scarcity of raw materials, energy crisis, inefficient administration, etc. Sixth problem is heavy demand. Even at low per capita consumption rate, demand for iron and steel is increasing with each passing day, and large quantities of iron and steel are to be imported for meeting the demands. Production has to be increased to save precious foreign exchange. Seventh point, shortage of metallurgical coal. Although India has huge deposits of high-grade iron ore, her coal reserves, especially high-grade coking coal for smelting iron and are limited. Many steel plants are forced to import metallurgical coal. For example, steel plant and Visakhapatnam has to import coal from Australia. Serious thought is now being given to replace imported coal by natural gas from Krishna Godavari Basin. So we can summarize this session by to it, and this session can enable the students to go through the thorough understanding of the growth, location and problems of iron and steel industry in India.